students, welcome back to today's science class. So we will be continuing with the same topic, that is materials, metals and non-metals. And the topic which we are going to take up today is the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. And in this topic we are going to discuss about the reaction of metals and non-metals with oxygen and water. Fine. So before that, let us recall what we have done in the previous class. In the previous class, you have learned about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. So the physical properties of metals are that metals are malleable, ductile, lustrous, hard, good conductor of heat and electricity. On the other hand, non-metals are non-malleable, non-ductile, non-lustrous, soft and bad conductor of heat and electricity. Metals and non-metals have various uses. So we have also discussed about the different uses depending on the property of metals and non-metals. Fine. So now let's look into the objectives of today's class. The objectives of today's class is to study about the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. So as I mentioned before, that we'll be studying about the reaction of metals and non-metals with oxygen and water. And you'll also find out how metals and non-metals react with oxygen and water, because all metals do not react in the same way. Fine. So it depends on the reactivity of the metals. So you'll find out how metals react with oxygen and water, and also you'll come to know how non-metals react with oxygen and water. Okay. So let us begin today's class. Children, you have already learned about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. So today we are going to discuss about the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Fine. So first we'll be discussing about the chemical properties of metals, and then we'll go for the non-metals. Okay. Now first we'll discuss how metals react with oxygen. Okay. Now before we go to the discussion of how metals react with oxygen, we need to know the reactivity series. Now what is reactivity series? Okay. Reactivity series is a list of the metals which are arranged in a descending order of their reactivity. Fine. So you can see on the board that the metals are arranged vertically in order of its decreasing reactivity. Fine. So you find that the top place is occupied by potassium, and then sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron. Yes. And then it will move down. Fine. So some metals are very reactive and some are less reactive and few are unreactive. Fine. So it depends on the reactivity of the metals. Okay. So since you have understood what is reactivity metals, the reactivity of metals, now let us understand how metals react with oxygen. So metals usually react with oxygen to produce metal oxide. Fine. So metal reacts with oxygen to produce metal oxide, and the metal oxide is basic in nature. Fine. So you have studied about acids and base in class 7. Fine. So it is basic in nature. That means the metal oxide which is produced will turn the red litmus paper, what? It will turn it into blue. So it's basic in nature. Fine. So now let's take few examples. Sodium reacts with oxygen to produce sodium oxide, and potassium reacts with oxygen to produce potassium oxide. Now you can see on the list that sodium and potassium are at the topmost position in the reactivity series. Fine. That means they are very reactive metals. Fine. So they are so reactive that they will react with oxygen present in air at room temperature. and this is why these metals are stored under kerosene or paraffin so that it do not react with the oxygen in the atmosphere. Fine. So it reacts with oxygen in the atmosphere and it starts burning very vigorously. It reacts very vigorously. Okay. Now what happens is some metal oxides react with water to produce metal hydroxide also. Fine. So next we have magnesium, the metal magnesium. So you'll find the metal magnesium below calcium. Okay, so that means magnesium is not as reactive as potassium and sodium. It is less reactive. So it will not react at room temperature. When magnesium is ignited, it burns, giving out white dazzling light. Fine. So magnesium will react with oxygen to produce what? It will react with oxygen to produce magnesium oxide. Okay. Now, here you have to note one thing that the metals do not react with oxygen in the similar way. Some metals will react at room temperature, some metals react when it is heated, and some other metals will react when it is strongly heated. Fine. So there are also metals which has to be heated for a long time. Prolonged heating has to be done. Fine. So aluminium reacts with oxygen to produce aluminium oxide. Zinc reacts with oxygen to produce zinc oxide, and zinc has to be heated strongly in order to react with oxygen. Fine. And you'll find that I've written amphoteric oxide. So what is this amphoteric oxide? The metal oxide which shows basic as well as acidic behavior is called amphoteric oxide. Fine. And the examples of amphoteric oxide are aluminium oxide and zinc oxide. Okay. Now iron, which you can see is less reactive than the other metals. So iron usually, when iron is heated, you'll find that iron becomes red hot. Fine. But if iron filings are sprinkled into flame, you'll find that it will burn vigorously and it will react with oxygen to produce what? It will produce iron 2 and 3 oxide. Fine. Similarly, copper, you can see that it is very less reactive. Fine. So it has to be heated for a long time. Prolonged heating has to be done, and then oxygen will copper will react with oxygen to produce a black substance called copper oxide. Fine. So this is how metals react with oxygen. All metals do not react in the similar manner. Some metals which are more reactive will react more vigorously, and then those which are less reactive, they will react less vigorously. Fine. But whatever be the case, when metals react with oxygen, what will it produce? It will produce metal oxide. Fine. Now children, let us see how metals react with water. Fine. So I already mentioned that it depends on the reactivity of the metal, how vigorous will be the reaction. Fine. So when metal reacts with water, whether it is hot or cold water, it will be producing metal hydroxide and hydrogen. Remember, when metal reacts with cold or hot water, it will produce metal hydroxide and hydrogen. But when metals react with steam, okay, when metals react with steam, it will produce metal oxide and hydrogen. Fine. So this is the difference between when metal reacts with cold or hot water and steam. So when it reacts with cold or hot water, it produces what? Metal hydroxide and hydrogen. And when it reacts with steam, it will produce metal oxide and hydrogen. Fine. Now let's understand the reaction of metal with the water by taking some examples. Fine. So we'll again start with potassium and sodium, since they are the most reactive metals in the reactivity series. Fine. So when potassium
reacts with hydrogen, it will produce potassium hydroxide and hydrogen. And along with hydrogen, it will produce a lot of heat. Fine. So the reactions in which heat is produced, that reaction is also called exothermic reaction. Okay. And when potassium reacts with water and it produces potassium hydroxide and hydrogen, the hydrogen will immediately burn because of the lot of heat which is produced, and this makes the reaction very vigorous. Fine. So similarly, sodium also reacts with water to produce sodium hydroxide, hydrogen and a lot of heat. So if this two will be able to react with cold water. Fine. Calcium also reacts with cold water to produce calcium hydroxide and hydrogen and a little bit of heat. It will not produce as much heat which is produced by what? The reaction of potassium and sodium with water. Fine. Okay. Now let's move to the next metal. Since magnesium is less reactive than these three metals, yes, potassium, sodium and calcium, so magnesium do not react with cold water. It will react with hot water. Fine. So it will react with hot water and it will produce magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen. Okay. And you can see that I have written G, A, Q, L here in bracket. Fine. S. So this denotes the physical state of this. Fine. So this will denote the physical state. S means solid, L means liquid, AQ means aqueous and G means gas. Fine. So hydrogen which is produced is in gaseous form. Okay. Now you find that magnesium will also react with steam and it will produce magnesium oxide. Fine. So this time the same metal is reacting with water. Fine. But once it reacts with hot water and produces magnesium hydroxide, and then when it reacts with steam, it produces magnesium oxide. Fine. So I have already mentioned that when metals react with steam, it produces metal oxide. So the metal magnesium will react both with hot water and steam. Let us take some more example. Metals like aluminium, zinc and iron do not react with cold water or hot water. It will react only with steam. Fine. So aluminium will react with water, that is in steam form. Yes, with water to form what? Aluminium oxide and hydrogen. Similarly, zinc will react with water, that is steam again, to produce zinc oxide and hydrogen, and red hot iron. The iron has to be red hot, and then it will react with water to produce iron 2-3 oxide and hydrogen. Metals that are more reactive will react more vigorously with water, and the metals which have less reactivity will react less vigorously, or it will react under normal condition. So this is how metals react with water. Now children, since you have understood how metals react with the oxygen and water, now let's understand how non-metal reacts with oxygen and water. Fine. So reaction of non-metals with oxygen. Non-metal react with oxygen to produce non-metal oxide, and the non-metal oxide can be acidic or neutral in nature. So let's understand by taking some examples. Carbon is a non-metal and it reacts with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, and it is acidic in nature. That means the non-metal oxide, carbon dioxide, is acidic in nature, and when the carbon dioxide reacts with water, yes, with reacts with water, this is not the non-metal, this is the non-metal oxide. Fine. So when the non-metal oxide, acidic non-metal oxide, reacts with water, it will produce acid, and in this case carbon dioxide reacts with water to produce carbonic acid. Fine. So similarly, if carbon is reacting in limited supply, that means the complete combustion of carbon does not take place, then it will produce carbon monoxide. But carbon monoxide is neutral in nature, and as a result, when this gas is reacting with water, it will not produce any acid. Fine, because it's not an acidic oxide. Fine. So carbon, when reacts with oxygen in limited supply of air, it will produce carbon monoxide, which is neutral in nature. Now let's look at the next example, that is sulfur. Sulfur, when reacts with oxygen, will give sulfur dioxide, which is also acidic in nature. Since sulfur dioxide is acidic in nature, when it reacts with the water, it will produce an acid. Yes, so it will produce sulfurous acid. Fine. So hydrogen is another non-metal which reacts with oxygen to produce water, but it will produce a non-metal oxide which is neutral in nature. Fine. So this is how the non-metal reacts with oxygen, and it reacts with oxygen to produce non-metal oxide, which may be acidic or neutral in nature. Okay, non-metals do not react with water. It does not react with hot water or cold water or even with steam. Yes, so the it does not have any reaction with water. Fine. So this is what we have for today's class. I hope that all of you have understood. And now let's summarize what we have learned. Children, in today's class we have learned that generally when metals are reacted with oxygen, they will form metallic oxide. These metallic oxides are basic in nature. Some metals react very vigorously with water, like in case of sodium. So it is stored in kerosene oil. Some metals react with water to form metal oxide and metal hydroxide. Hydrogen gas is released in this reaction. On the other hand, some metal reacts very slowly with water, like in case of iron. Oxides of non-metals are formed when non-metals react with oxygen. The oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature and turn blue litmus to red, or it may also be neutral in nature. Fine. So non-metals do not react with water. So I hope that all of you have understood what has been explained in today's class. So children, I am not giving any questions for today. What you need to do is you have to write down the equations which has been shown. Fine. So I'll be sending you the picture of the equation. Okay. So you have to write down everything in your copy. So thank you and have a nice day.